Friends, in this video, we are going to study about electric dipole. Electric dipole happens to be a system of two equal and opposite charges separated by very small distance. So here you can see I have got two charges of equal magnitude. Both charges are of magnitude Q, but their nature is opposite. One is minus Q, another one is plus Q. And they are separated by a distance of 2L. This distance 2L is supposed to be very, very small. Electric dipole is basically a molecular structure, for example, HCl. So if you are looking for HCl, H generally has a polarity of positive charge and chloride Cl generally has a polarity of minus charge. So the distance of separation between these two will be of atomic order. Remember friends, electric dipoles are generally possess a very small distances between them. So that is the reason why it is necessary for us to take the distance between the two charges to be very small. Now, an imaginary line which basically joins the two charges. So you can see over here, there is an imaginary line which is joining the two charges. This imaginary line is referred by us as dipole axis. Now, the length of this dipole axis, as I told you, is considered as 2L. Now, it is a convention of taking this length as 2L. It could have been also taken as L, but as the convention we follow it as 2L. Now, any line that happens to pass through the dipole axis, parallel to the dipole axis, is called as axial line, while any line which divides the dipole axis into two equal parts is called as equatorial line or simply neutral line. So the line which is dividing the dipole axis, you can see this is a line which is dividing the dipole axis into two equal parts. This particular line, perpendicular line, is called as equatorial or neutral line. Now, any point that happens to lie on the equatorial line is referred as equatorial position, or it is also referred as broadside on position, and in some tan cases they might be also referred as tan B position, friends. So any point that happens to lie on the equatorial line is going to be called as equatorial position, broadside on position, or tan B position. Similarly, any point that happens to lie on the axis of the dipole axis or on the axial line of the dipole axis is called as axial position or end on position or tan A position, friends. Mostly they are referred as axial or equatorial positions. This one is called as axial position and this one is called as equatorial position. A dipole, since it consists of two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance, mostly the dipole is defined in terms of a physical quantity which is called as dipole moment. Now, dipole moment is obtained as the product of magnitude of any of these charges. So we just take the magnitude. Remember friends, I am again and again emphasizing on the fact that in electrostatics formula, it's always the magnitude of the charge that you take into consideration, not the sign of the charges. So, dipole moment is defined as the product of the magnitude of the charges and the length of the dipole axis. You can simply say as the distance of separation between the two charges. So, it is the product of magnitude and the distance of separation between the two charges. So here in this expression Q stands for magnitude. Please take care, it's again I'm reminding you all, it's the magnitude of charge, and 2L happens to be the distance of separation. It is distance of separation between the two charges. So we are considering this particular distance. This is the distance between the two charges, okay? And that what we have taken it as 2L. So that's how you define the dipole moment. Now remember, friends, dipole moment itself is a vector quantity, and the direction of the dipole moment is directed from the negative charge to the positive charge. So dipole moment is a vector quantity, and the sense of direction, you can see that sense of direction associated with the dipole, and the sense of direction is directed from the negative charge to the positive charge. Now whenever a dipole is going to be defined, remember, it is going to be defined in terms of the dipole moment, and you need to specify its direction, and the direction of the dipole moment will be from negative to positive charge. Now SI unit of dipole moment, it is, since it is a product of magnitude of charge and distance, so SI unit happens to be coulomb meter, and whose dimensions comes out to be L into T into A. Now friends, let's try to determine net electric field due to an electric dipole. You can see here is an electric dipole whose dipole moment is P. At some point A on the axial position, the distance of A from the middle or the midpoint of the dipole axis is R. Similarly, in the second part of the question, you need to determine the electric field at some point B, once again located at a distance R from the middle of the dipole axis. So let's find out electric field at point A, which happens to be the axial position of this dipole. Friends, in order to find out the electric field at point A, we will be using the result that we have derived in electric field due to point charge. Now I believe you all must have watched that video. If you haven't, you can always click on the top right hand corner and get the link of the electric field due to the point. In that video, we learned that electric field due to any point charge is given by the formula 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught magnitude of the charge Q upon R square, where Q was the, as I told you, magnitude of charge, magnitude of source charge. Source charge is the charge due to which we are trying to find out the electric field, and this R in that expression used to be the distance between the source charge and the point where the electric field needs to be calculated. Distance between the source charge and the point where the electric field was supposed to be calculated. Here we are interested in finding out the electric field at point A. So in this case, distance should be taken from the source charge. Suppose I need to find out the electric field due to this negative charge, then I will be taking the distance from point X to point A, or XA distance. Similarly, if I need to find out the electric field due to this positive charge, then I am going to take this distance, that is the distance from positive charge Y to point A. So friends, let's try to find out the distances and the electric field due to the individual charges. And then, since there are two charges whose electric field is going to act at point A, then I will be using the result from the principle of superposition to determine the net electric field. Now, let's begin by finding out the electric field due to the negative charge. Now, due to the negative charge, this is my negative charge, the electric field will be directed radially inwards. So the direction of the electric field will be radially inwards. The expression of this electric field will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R plus L whole square, friends. Now, why R plus L whole square? As you can see, m is the midpoint, so this distance will be l. Similarly, this distance will also be l, m being the midpoint. Now, I am interested in finding out the distance from the source charge to the point A. That is, I am interested in finding out this distance x to A. Now, x to A distance will be made up of xm, which is l, plus my. So, xA distance will be equal to xm plus ma. Xm is how much? That is l. Ma is how much? That is r. So, xA will be r plus l. And that is the reason why in this expression I have substituted it as r plus l whole square. And since this electric field is acting in the radially inwards direction, that is negative x-axis, or along the left hand side, so I have written down this electric field as minus I cap. Similarly, electric field due to this positive charge, friends, will be directed radially outwards. So, electric field due to the positive charge is directed radially outwards. So, this direction is plus I cap, and the expression of the electric field will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, magnitude of the charge. What is the magnitude of this positive charge? That is also q. And then distance ka square. What is the distance between the point A and the positive charge? This distance is yA, isn't it? So what is yA now? In order to get yA, you can see yA is nothing but MA minus MY, isn't it? So, MA minus MY, MA minus MY. What is MA, friends? MA was R. What is MY? MY happens to be this distance L. So, YA happens to be R minus L. And thus, this distance is substituted over here. So, this becomes R minus L ka whole square. So, this is the way you will find out the electric field due to the negative charge and due to the positive charge. Now, at point A, there are two electric fields that are acting simultaneously. One due to the negative charge and another due to the positive charge, friends. So, the net electric field will then be the vector sum of electric field due to the negative charge and electric field due to the positive charge. So, this is according to the principle of superposition. So, in your earlier discussion, you have already learned about this particular principle, principle of superposition. So, what I am going to do, I am going to substitute the electric field due to the negative charge and the electric field due to the positive charge and then simplify the result so obtained. In order to simplify the expression that we have obtained, I have taken q upon 4 pi epsilon naught outside the bracket and I cap also outside the bracket. So, inside the bracket I am left with minus 1 upon r plus l ka whole square plus 1 upon r minus l ka whole square, friends. Friends, you can pause the video and you may try to simplify this expression on your own. Please do that so that you can learn the step of mathematical simplification. Okay, friends, let's move further ahead. Now, inside this bracket, I will take the LCM of r plus l ka whole square into r minus l ka whole square, and then in the numerator, I will get minus times of r minus l ka whole square. This goes in the numerator on this left hand side, while this goes to the numerator on the right hand side. So, plus r plus l ka whole square, friends. Friends, now from the algebra, you already know the expansion of a minus b whole square. What is the expansion of a minus b whole square? That happens to be a square plus b square and minus 2ab. Similarly, the expansion of a plus b ka whole square will be a square plus b square plus 2ab. So, what I have done, I'm going to expand this term r minus l ka whole square and I'm going to expand r plus l ka whole square in my next step. So, r minus l ka whole square कम्स आउट टू बी आर प्लस एल होल स्क्वायर, सॉरी आर माइनस एल का होल स्क्वायर विल बी आर स्क्वायर प्लस एल स्क्वायर माइनस टू एल आर. सिमिलरली आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सपैंड आर प्लस एल का होल स्क्वायर एंड आई विल गेट आर स्क्वायर प्लस एल स्क्वायर प्लस टू एल आर. नाउ आई वॉज हैविंग माइनस ओवर हियर, सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक दिस माइनस एंड मल्टीप्लाई थ्रू द एंटायर ऑल दीज टर्म्स. सो माई एक्सप्रेशन नाउ लुक्स लाइक माइनस आर स्क्वायर माइनस एल स्क्वायर माइनस एंड माइनस कंबाइन टूगेदर टू गिव मी प्लस ओवर हियर, एंड ओवर हियर आई विल गेट आर स्क्वायर प्लस एल स्क्वायर प्लस टू एल आर. नाउ यू कैन सी हियर आई हैव गॉट इन द न्यूमरेटर माइनस आर स्क्वायर एंड हियर आई हैव गॉट प्लस आर स्क्वायर. सो दिस माइनस आर स्क्वायर एंड दिस प्लस आर स्क्वायर विल कैंसिल आउट ईच अदर. सिमिलरली आई हैव गॉट माइनस एल स्क्वायर एंड प्लस एल स्क्वायर ओवर हियर. Once again, minus L square and plus L square will cancel out each other. So what I am left with? I am left in the numerator with 2LR from this term and 2LR from this term, which on combining them together will become 4LR, friends. Isn't it? So the numerator of this will become 4LR and in the denominator I am going to have R plus L ka square into R minus L ka whole square. So I am rewriting this expressions once again after simplification, friends, and it comes out to be q upon 4 pi epsilon naught 4 lr upon r plus l whole square into r minus l ka square. Now friends, you can see this is one term and this is another term. Let me call this term as x and this term as y. So this is nothing but x square into y square. Now this x square into y square can also be written as x y ka whole square, isn't it? So that's what I am going to do in the next step of mine. So what I have done, you can see over here, I have written down it as r plus l into r minus l ka whole square. Now from algebra, once again, you know a plus b, when multiplied with a minus b, it used to give me a square minus b square, isn't it? So this is my r plus l and this is my r minus l. When they are going to be multiplied, they are going to give me r square minus l square. Isn't it, friends? And then I've got this whole square. So ultimately it will be my whole square. Have you understood this step, friends? Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to simplify this. And then the result will look like something. Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. 4 LR in the numerator part. As you can see over there. And this has been now R square minus L square ka whole square. And I cap was already there. Now. So, rearranging all these terms and this 4LR over here, I am rewriting it as, can you see, I have broken 4 as 2 into 2L. Is that okay? 4 has been written as 2 into 2L into R. Now, I am taking this 2L outside and placing it with Q. So the expression now looks like Q into 2L upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2R upon R square minus L square ka whole square. Why I have done? I have purposely done this step. Why? Because for any dipole, this quantity Q into 2L is nothing but its dipole moment, friends. So this Q into 2L becomes my dipole moment of this dipole. So in the above expression now I have got, or rather I am going to replace this Q into 2L by the dipole moment P upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2R upon R square minus L square ka whole square. Now this is my dipole moment for the dipole. So this gives the expression for electric field due to any dipole at its axial position. And you should take care that this electric field at the axial position will always be directed along the positive I cap, because E plus was greater in comparison to E minus. So the net electric field will be directed along the positive X axis, which you can also see is parallel to the direction of the dipole moment. It is similar to the direction of the dipole moment. Dipole moment is also directed from positive x axis. So do the electric field on the axial line is also directed along the positive x axis. This particular expression that you have obtained over here is the expression for electric field due to any dipole. Now what we are going to do, we will approximate this result for electric field due to a short dipole. Now in order to get the electric field due to the short dipole, in case of short dipole, the distance L is going to be very, very small. So for any short dipole, the distance L is very, very small. So when I am going to square a smaller quantity, it will become eventually further very, very small. So I can say that L square will be further very, very smaller than R square. So what would happen? Since L square is very, very smaller to R square, then in this expression, friends, R square minus L square, I can neglect L square as it is very, very small in comparison to R. So what I am doing, I can neglect R square in the expression R square minus L square. I am going to neglect this factor. Why I am neglecting it? Because this is a very small quantity. So what I will be left with, I am going to left with only R square. So the result will now look like, this is now been approximated. R square minus L square has been approximated to R square. So my result will look like P upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 R upon R square ka whole square. So R square and square, that will become R to the power of 4, and this R to the power of 4 cancels out to give me R cube. So for a short dipole, the net electric field comes out to be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P upon R cube. So this is the expression for the electric field due to a short dipole at its axial or end on position. Now friends, let's move on to determine the electric field at point B, that is the broadside on position of the electric dipole. And this point B is situated once again at a distance of R from the midpoint or from the middle of the dipole axis. Now friends, this distance, that is the distance from negative charge to the point B, happens to be XB, and the distance of the positive charge from point B happens to be YB. Remember friends, electric field was defined due to a point charge, and electric field due to a point charge was given by the expression E is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. Now what is Q in this expression? That was the magnitude of the source charge. What is X? X used to be the distance between the source charge and the point B. So here in this case, for negative charge, this distance will be XB, and for this distance, for the positive charge, it will be this distance YB. So I need to know these two distances, friends. So I need to find out this distance and this distance. Now for, in order to find out this distance, you can see M being the midpoint, so this distance will be L, and this distance will also be L. This is R, and this will be my right angle triangle. Whose this angle, let's assume it to be theta. So this angle is not known to me, let me assume this angle to be theta. Then I can find out this distance XB with the help of Pythagoras theorem under the root of R square plus L square. Similarly, in this triangle also, this distance YB can be found out to be equal to under the root of R square plus L square, friends. Isn't it? So you notice that XB and YB are equal in magnitude. So this angle is theta, so similarly this angle will also be theta. Now due to this negative charge, the electric field will be directed radially inwards. Thus the magnitude of electric field due to the negative charge will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q, that is the magnitude of the source charge, upon this distance square, and this distance was XB. So XB square will be R square plus L square, friends. Isn't it? So this comes out to be R square plus L square, friends. This is the expression for the negative electric field due to the negative charge. Now, due to the positive charge, electric field will be directed radially outwards, and thus the expression for the electric field due to the positive charge will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon the distance from the source charge to the point B, and that distance was yb square. So yb square will be r square plus l square. Yb square will be r square plus l square. So substituting the same over here. Now this is directed radially outwards. Now friend, this angle, as I told you, was theta, and this angle was also theta because xb was equal to yb, hence the triangles were isosceles triangle. So this exterior angle will eventually be 2 theta. So this angle eventually will be 2 theta. This angle phi will be 2 theta. So what I am doing, I am going to find out the net resultant electric field, and in order to get the net resultant electric field, once again I am going to use the vector sum. And if you can recall from your class 11th vector, resultant of two vectors, the net resultant of two vectors was given by the formula r is equals to under the root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos alpha, where alpha used to be the angle between the two vectors. So here the angle between e minus and e plus was phi. So e minus square plus e plus square plus 2e minus e plus into cos. So substituting the value of phi as 2 theta in this expression, and taking e minus this value as equal to e, and similarly this value will also be equal to e, so the expression will now look like e square plus 2, e minus is e, e plus is also e, so 2e square into cos 2 theta. Now e square plus e square will be 2e square, so 2e square plus 2e square cos 2 theta, you can club 2e square common from this expression. So what I will be left with, 1 plus cos 2 theta, and 1 plus cos 2 theta is nothing but 2 cos square theta. Now how do we have obtained this result? This is with the help of trigonometrical identities, friends. Cos 2 theta in trigonometrical identity was obtained as 2 cos square theta minus 1. Now those who haven't opted for mathematics, friends, in at class 11, 12th level, I will ask you to remember this result, and this is going to be much more useful result for you all at different levels of physics derivation. Cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. Therefore, taking this one on this side, so 1 plus cos 2 theta will be equal to 2 cos square theta. Now, this 1 plus cos 2 theta has been now substituted as 2 cos square theta in this expression, isn't it? So what I have got now, 2e square into 2 cos square theta, that is 4e square cos square theta, which on simplifying will become e net is equals to 2e cos theta. So this is the expression for net electric field at point B, in which e is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square plus l square, and cos theta can be easily obtained with the help of this right angle triangle. And in this right angle triangle, you can see that cos theta is nothing but base upon hypotenuse. And what is the base of the triangle? That is L, and hypotenuse happens to be under the root of. So this will become L upon under the root of R square plus L square. So under the root, the power becomes half. So that is what I am going to substitute it over there in the above expression. So 2, I have substituted the value of E into cos theta. As I told you, cos theta is nothing but L upon r square plus l square whole ki power half, and then on rearranging the terms, 2ql in the numerator, 4 pi epsilon naught in the denominator, r square plus l square was already there, and r square plus l square whole ki power half was there. So combining them together, it becomes r square plus l square whole ki power 3 by 2 minus I cap. Friends, now you have to understand the direction of this electric field. See, E plus and E minus both have got equal magnitude. both had got the same magnitude E, whose value was 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus L square. So the net electric field will now be directed along the angular bisector. So this net electric field will be directed along the angular bisector. Once again, if you are not aware of all these formulas, I would request you to go and watch my video on vectors. So E net is directed, you can see E net is directed along the negative x axis or minus I cap. That's the reason why you can see I have put down this particular minus I cap over here, because this net resultant electric field is going to be directed along the angular bisector. Now rearranging the terms, so the numerator, I am rewriting it down as the numerator over here. I am rewriting down this numerator as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and 2QL as Q into 2L, because Q into 2L has got a physical significance. What does Q into 2L stands for a dipole? It happens to be the dipole moment of a dipole. So Q into 2L happens to be the dipole moment of the dipole P. So I am going to replace this as P. So this becomes P upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus L square whole ki power 3 by 2. And as I told you, the net electric field is directed along the negative of the x axis. And on rearranging the term, the expressions looks like E net is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus P cap. Why are you using the term minus P cap for electric field at the equatorial position? As I told you, the electric field at this equatorial position is directed along the negative of the x-axis. Now, since it is directed along the negative of the x-axis, while the dipole moment is directed along the positive of the x-axis, so the electric field is just opposite to the dipole moment, friends. So that is the reason why in this expression I have taken out this minus I cap and I have put minus P or minus dipole moment vector, so that the net electric field at the equatorial position can be understood to be directed opposite to the dipole moment of the of any electric dipole, friends. So this is the expression for the electric field due to any dipole at its equatorial position. Now, for any short dipole, as I told you earlier also, L is going to be very small in comparison to R. So L square will be further very smaller than R square. Now when L square is very smaller than R square, then I can neglect this L over here in comparison to R square. So R square plus L square will now be approximately equal to L square only. So this R square plus L square is now approximated to R square only. So this becomes R square whole ki power 3 by 2. Now this 2 and this 2 cancels out. So what I am left with? This 2 and this 2 will cancel out. So what I am left with in the denominator? R cube, friends. So electric field at the equatorial position due to a short dipole comes out to be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus P upon R cube. So this is the expression for electric field due to a short dipole on its equatorial position or broadside or position, friends. Friends, let's summarize what we have understood. Now, electric field due to a short dipole, why I am interested now only in the short dipole? Because most of the numerical problems are applicable only for a short dipole. So you should know the result for the short dipole rather than the result for the general dipole. So electric field due to a short dipole at point A. What is point A, friends? What is this point A? A point happens to be the axial position. Is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2p upon r cube, and this electric field was directed along the direction of the dipole moment. So this is the dipole moment and the electric field is also directed along the direction of dipole moment. Now due to the short dipole, the electric field at broadside on position was 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught minus p upon r cube, isn't it? That is, the electric field at broadside on position is directed opposite to the direction of dipole moment. So remember these two very important aspects. Electric field at axial position is directed along the direction of dipole moment, And electric field at broadside on position is directed opposite to the direction of dipole moment. So when I compare these two results, I can very easily conclude that the electric field at axial position is twice that of electric field at the equatorial position. And you see this factor is double. So I can say it is twice of this. And also if you notice, then you can also conclude that the direction of the electric field at the axial position is directed opposite to the direction of electric field at equatorial position. So to summarize the result, I can say for a short dipole, electric field due to short dipole on its axial position is double to that of electric field at its equatorial position, and they are directed opposite to each other, friends. So this was all about the electric field due to a dipole on its axial and equatorial position. Take care about them, learn them, practice them. They are important for any test or any type of examination, friends. Friends, thank you for watching. Don't forget to give a like or comment. Agar abhi tak aapne mere channel ko subscribe nahi kiya hai, to please do the same. Don't forget to hit the bell icon so that whenever a new video is loaded, you get the notification. Take care, and we will meet back again with a new video and a new solution. Thank you, friends.